By now, you already learned quite some things in R. Data structures such as vectors, matrices, and lists have no more secrets for you. However, R is a statistical programming language, and in statistics, you'll often be working with datasets. Such datasets are typically comprised of observations or instances. All these observations have some variables associated with them. You can have, for example, a dataset of 5 people. Each person is an instance, and the properties about these people, such as, for example, their name, their age, and whether they have children, are the variables. How could you store such information in R? In a matrix, maybe? Not really, because the name would be a character and the age would be a numeric, but these don't fit in a matrix. In the list, maybe. This could work, because you can put practically anything in a list. You could create a list of lists, where each sublist is a person with a name, an age, and so on. However, the structure of such a list is not really useful to work with. What if you want to know all the ages, for example? You'd have to write a lot of R code just to get what you want. But what data structure could we use then? Meet the data frame. It's the fundamental data structure to store typical datasets. It's pretty similar to a matrix because it also has rows and columns. Also for data frames, the rows correspond to the observations, the persons in our example, while the columns correspond to the variables, or the properties of each of these persons. The big difference with matrices is that a data frame can contain elements of different types. One column can contain characters, another one numerics, and yet another one logicals. That's exactly what we need to store our person's information in a dataset, right? We could have a column for the name, which is character, one for the age, which is numeric, and one logical column to denote whether the person has children. There still is a restriction on the data types, though. Elements in the same column should be of the same type. But that's not really a problem, because in one column, the age column for example, you'll always want a numeric, because an age is always a number, regardless of the observation. So, for the practical part now, creating a data frame. In most cases, you don't create a data frame yourself. Instead, you typically import data from another source. This could be a CSV file, a relational database, but could also come from other software packages, like Excel or SPSS. Of course, R provides a way to manually create data frames as well. You could use the data.frame function for this. To create our people data frame that has 5 observations and 3 variables, we'll have to pass the data frame function 3 vectors that are all of length 5. The vectors you pass correspond to the columns. Let's create these 3 vectors first: name, age, and child. Now, calling the data frame function is simple. The printout of the data frame already shows very clearly that we're dealing with a dataset. Notice how the data frame function inferred the names of the columns from the variable names you passed it. To specify the names explicitly, you can use the same techniques as for vectors and lists. You can use a names function, or use equal signs inside the data frame function to name the data frame columns right away. Like in matrices, it's also possible to name the rows of the data frame, but that's generally not a good idea, so I won't go into detail on that here. Before you head over to some exercises, let me shortly discuss the structure of a data frame some more. If you look at the structure, there are 2 things you can see here. First, the printout looks suspiciously similar to that of a list. That's because under the hood, the data frame actually is a list. In this case, it's a list with 3 elements, corresponding to each of the columns in the data frame. Each list element is a vector of length 5, corresponding to the number of observations. A requirement that is not present for lists is that the length of the vectors you put in the list has to be equal. If you try to create a data frame with 3 vectors that are not all of the same length, you'll get an error. Second, the name column, which you expect to be a character vector, is actually a factor. That's because R, by default, stores the strings as factors. To suppress this behavior, you can set the strings as factors argument of the data frame function to false. Now, the name column actually contains characters. With this new knowledge, you're ready for some first exercises on this extremely useful and powerful data structure. Whenever you're experimenting with data frames, remember that they're actually lists. This gives the data frame the ability to store vectors of different types. On top of that, R also has some additional functionality built in to easily extend and subset data frames. I'll talk more about that in the next video.